It's all over.
It is all over.
to those who love God, and to those who are called according to his purpose. Just do me a favor, turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, it will work out. It will work out. Are we speaking to somebody already? Somebody need to hear that, amen. Somebody was wondering how it was going to work out, but it will. And we declare and decree today, right now, that it will. That's a confirmation, that's a declaration, that's a decree. I don't care what it looks like, but it will work out. Can I get a witness? In life, things do not always work out the way we want them to. Can I get a witness? Or even work out the way we plan them to. In life, there will be trouble, tribulation, persecution, disappointments, change of plans. Amen. There will be its in life. Things. Life is difficult. And sometimes it does not make sense at all. Can I get a witness? We have seasons where we are just plain old stuck. Anybody ever had a season like that? Stuck. And we cannot always see how our lives will be better. We cannot always see a way out. We cannot always see how things are going to work out. But I declare and decree to you this morning that it will work out. How will it all work out? Some of us spend some sleepless nights wondering how it all will work out. When you have bills that are bigger than money, how will it all work out? You've been given a diagnosis by the doctor. Sometimes you wonder, how will it all work out? We have all experienced an it at some point in our lives. Can I get a word? Some of us have an it right now. Here it is again. Here it go again. I just can't seem to get over it. It is killing me. It follows me. It calls me. It worries me. It bothers me. We all have an it. It. Somebody say it.
Yes.
Anybody have an it?
Yes.
Some people have its. Can I get a witness? If it ain't one thing, it's another.
Yes, sir.
Someone here this morning needs a word of encouragement. And a word of assurance that whatever it is, it will work out. You've been bringing and carrying that it for a long time. Some of us have a visible it, some of us have an invisible it. Some of us have an it we don't want anybody to know about. Amen. Somebody have an it that it really wasn't our fault. But you trust the wrong people. Can I get a witness? And you develop the it. Some of us got an it on our jobs. Amen. It! But it will work out. There are God-given tools that all believers must be aware of in order to navigate through it. Amen. It's right there in the text. So I'm going to give you five of these tools, and we're going to see if we can leave out of here knowing that it will work out. The first tool God gives us is his patience. His patience. You have had to have his patience. Because it was trying your last nerve. Amen. And some of us have just a half a nerve left. And it is trying that. Can I get a witness? And you want to deal with it. But thank God for his patience. It'll hold you down for a minute, won't it? You see, God is working it out at his pace, not yours. Let me say that again. God is working it out at his pace. And sometimes we go, God, don't you know about it? Can't you see it? And God sees it, amen, but he's patient. Because God already knows how it is going to work out. And all you got to do is trust and believe, amen, that God knows about it, God sees it, and God is dealing with it. But he's dealing with it at his own pace. And I don't know about you, but I know that if we wait on God and we deal with God's pace, amen, God is always on time. I wish I had a witness here today. God is always on time. You mess it up when you try to run ahead of God or when you try to play God to deal with it, amen. You have given it to God, so let God work it out. Am I talking to anybody yet? His patience. You see, God has his own plan for your life. You just have to trust his plan. You just have to trust his timing. Amen. God is, watch this, God is patient with us. Amen. Until our last breath. Amen. God is patient with us. We have told him, God, we're going to get it together. Lord, we ain't going back to it. Amen. But the next thing we know, amen, after we've promised God, never, amen, that we find ourselves going back to it. You know, sometimes it doesn't call you, sometimes you call it. Can I help somebody here today? You find yourself thinking about it. You know it ain't good for you. Can I get a witness? You know the history of it, amen. And you find yourself, something Paul said like this, but I want to do good. Come on. And I know what it is. Sometimes I find myself reaching out and going back for it. See, so you buried it in the cemetery, and then when things got a little rough, you went back to the cemetery and you buried it, you dug it back up. But God is patient with us, isn't he? He still, he see you walking with it, talking with it, driving it, putting up with it. Amen. And he is patient with us. You are still here because of his patience. Thank God he's patient. Amen. And so because God is patient, and this is a word for somebody here today, because God is patient, God is telling you, be patient. Be patient. Don't settle. Wait on the Lord. Can I get a witness? Wait on the Lord. Wait on him. Be patient. Well, that's a word for me. In fact, turn to your neighbor and say, be patient. It's going to work out. Just be patient. Chill. Can I get a witness? Just relax. Amen. Put your trust in the Lord. Chill out. Be patient. Not only is God, we need his patience, but we need his perception. How God sees it. You see, what is a problem to you is just an opportunity for God. Can I get a witness with you? Don't tell your problem. Don't tell God how big your it is. Tell your it how big your God is. You need to see it like God sees it. God said, oh, that ain't no problem. That's just an opportunity for me to show up and show out. Can I get a witness? You see, God sees what we cannot see. I wish I had some help. God knows what we do not know. We need to see it like God sees it. And God said, that ain't no problem. That's just an opportunity for me to show up and show out. You need to know what I can do, amen. So I have created this it and allowed it to be, amen, so I can show up and show out. And you let it cripple you, but it ain't designed to cripple you, because all things, all its, is working together for your good. Can I get a witness? Everything, the up and the down, is all working for your good. We need to see it like God sees it. I was on a plane one time, and the plane landed. And the people said that there was on the highway, there was a big accident. And the traffic was backed up. You were seeing traffic backed up.
Oh, yeah.
It was coming right into town. The person that came to pick me up at the airport said, you might need to take another way instead of going over Howard Franklin. Because Howard Franklin is almost shut down. Can I get a witness? They wanted to go another way. But I came in to Tampa high and lifted up in the air. And some flights go right over Howard Franklin. I saw the Howard Franklin. And the accident had been cleared up, and the traffic was moving. Amen. What am I trying to say here? See, the person saw it from their perception. Come on, somebody. But God is high and lifted up. He can see the whole panoramic view. Can I get a witness? He can see down the road. He can see all the way until tomorrow. Can I get a witness? And you thinking that is all one thing, but God, you got to see it the way God sees it. Come on, somebody. And God said, ain't no problem, baby. You just get on 275. It's going to be all right. Can I get a witness? It done cleared up, amen. Because God can see it from his view. And ain't nobody got a view like God. You are still here because of his perception. He knows that this is not going to take you out. It might feel that way. Can I get a witness? It might look that way. But we need to see it in God's perception, his perception. He says that all things, it's all working together. Just keep on going. It's going to be all right. I done cleared it, amen, before you got there, amen. It has been cleared up. You just get on the road. You say, but Lord, the traffic is all right here right now. It's all backed up right now. God says, just go on a little while longer. You ever been through some traffic and then you got to a certain point and it let up, amen? And you can go back to speeding with some of y'all do, amen. You just cussing and everything because it's back to back. As soon as you get that point where it cleared up, you say, thank you, Jesus, amen. Especially if you've been in traffic for a long time. You say, I've been in the storm too long, amen. And then it cleared up and you say, thank you, Jesus. Because you held on. Don't make a U-turn and go backwards, amen. Keep going forward because God sees that down the road everything will be all right. Not only must we use his patience and his perception, but we must see his plan. His plan.
Amen.
Did you know that God knows the plan for your life? Do you know that he has given you a plan? Jeremiah 29:11, so God says, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. God has already ordained all the things in your life. And every day is not going to be Sunday. But see, the race is not given to the swiftest and the strongest. It's the one who endures until the end. And when you know that God has a good plan for your life, and even though you might be going through some difficulty right now, but when you know that God has a plan for your life, and it's a good plan, amen, you can go through the storm. Can I get a witness? As a matter of fact, you can praise him in the midst of the problem because you know that God has a plan. Can I get a witness? You can know when till the battle is over, because baby, you're coming out, amen. Stop saying I'm going through and declare I'm coming out, amen. Some of you are saying I'm going through, but God wants you to say I'm coming out. As a matter of fact, somebody needs to declare that right now. Look at, touch yourself and say I'm coming out. I may be going through, but I'm coming out, amen. It ain't gonna be like this always. I'm coming out. Come on, I don't know about you, but I'm coming out. I can shout right now because I'm coming out. It ain't gonna be like this always. God is gonna deal with it, and I'm coming out. He had a plan, y'all, even before you were born. He told Jeremiah, he said, before I formed thee in the belly, your mama's belly, I knew you. Before I formed you in your mama's belly, I knew you. Before you came forth out of the womb, I sanctified you. Which means I put a plan over your life. I ordained for all the things that are going to happen in your life to happen. But it's all good, because everything is working together for your good. I don't care what it feels like right now. As a matter of fact, stop looking at your circumstances and understand God's plan. All right. Come on. Show you right. Amen. Yes. It's going to ordain you. I sanctified you, which means because I sanctified you, my plan is protecting you. What you're going through right now, my plan is keeping you. You are alive today because of the plan of God over your life. God ain't through with you yet. If you are sitting in this sanctuary, listening to this sermon, God ain't through with you yet. If you are online, listening to this word by live stream, God ain't through with you yet. If you have breath in your body, God ain't through with you yet. I don't care what it looks like, God ain't through with you yet. You are still here because of his plan. His plan for your life is still what's keeping you. Because his plan for your life brings also the power to walk right, the power to live, the power to get up in the morning, the power to go just a little while longer. Amen. You'd be surprised that God will give you strength to go through your it, because he knows the plan that he has for you. And the devil wants you to kind of commit spiritual suicide before it becomes realized, before it becomes fully recognized. He wants you to back up because of the circumstances, and he wants you to go back and commit spiritual suicide. But I ain't going back. Can I get a witness? I'm going to press on just a little while longer. I'm going to press toward the mark of the high calling which is found in Christ Jesus. It doesn't matter what I'm going through right now, I'm going to keep on pressing. It doesn't matter what the enemy is trying to do, I'm going to keep on pressing. It doesn't matter how my it is trying to stop me, I am going to keep on pressing. And it seems like I'm working against my it, but you ain't really working against your it. Come on, somebody. God is allowing it, amen, to get in the way so that he can show up and you can know that it was nobody but Jesus. Can I get a witness? So he has allowed it to be a reality so that he can get the glory when you come over it, when you come out of it. And you sitting there worried about it, amen. I said, don't worry about it. I got a better view, baby. I got a better view than you do. Thank you, Jesus. Not only do we need his patience, his perception, his plan, but we also need to know his purpose. You are saved for a purpose. God didn't save you just for no reason at all. All of the gifts that he has given you and the anointing that he has put on your life, it has a purpose. Everything happens for a reason. Everything is happening to you because of the purpose that God has spoken over your life. Amen. You got a purpose, and you ain't going nowhere until God says so. Amen. Amen. You ain't leaving here until God says so. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. The devil tried to say, yeah, you're done. You're pretty much done. Come on, somebody. But God said, not so. I got a purpose. You see, you made this choice to follow God's way for a purpose. You thought that you was really coming to the Lord, but the Lord was really drawing you. All of your life, all of your ups and downs, all of the things that you have gone through, God was pulling on you. Amen? Because he already knew his purpose over your life. He allowed you to go through some of the trials and the pits and the tribulations, not to take you out, but to build you, to make you stronger. Can I get a witness? The reason why you have some of the strength that you have today is because you know that God was there then, and God saw you through then, and you made it through that. Mommy said like this, what don't kill you? And I have gained most of my spiritual strength, not from my victories, but from my obstacles. God uses it. That problem, he uses it to bless you. I know that just sounds crazy, Pastor. Yeah, it sounds crazy. But you just hold on just a little while longer. Watch this. Didn't God work it out? Whatever your it out was before, didn't God work it out? Come on, somebody. That's what you shot right there. Yeah, you sure did, Lord. You worked it out. It ain't on me no more. I looked around and it was gone. Help me, Holy Ghost. The doctor said that it was going to take me out, but you said, no, it ain't going to take me out. You had me overcome it, amen. And you're the same God that dealt with that, that can deal with this. He's the same God. And he's the same God yesterday, today, and forever. Whatever it is, it won't mess with your purpose. It won't stand in the way of what God has ordained over your life. You are called and you are too anointed to die, amen, for where God has not ordained for you to die. I don't care what the enemy tries to do. I don't care what the enemy says. But what God says is what matters. And God said that. I will be all that he said I will be. God said I will do all that he says I will do. God says I will go all where he says I will go. And it doesn't matter what it looks like right now. You just hold on just for a little while longer. As a matter of fact, shout now because God is going to do it. He ain't a man that he should lie. Amen. He had a purpose over your life. Whatever it is, it will have to bless you. Let's chew on that for a minute. Whatever it is, it will have to bless you. God will make your enemies your footstools. Come on, can I get a witness? God will command it. Once he is done with it troubling you, then God will take the same thing that troubled you and now tell it to bless you. They won't even know why they're blessing you. Because they don't like you. And they wanted to take you out. Somebody said, I don't know why I'm doing this. Yeah, well, I know why you're doing it. Because my God has commanded you to do it. You were not designed to take me out. You were designed to build me. And now you're going to bless me. You are still here because of your purpose. And your purpose is keeping you. Thank you, Jesus. Let me conclude this. When we look at his patience, and we look at his perception, and we look at his plan, and when we look at his purpose, then we can see his power. His power. And we know. Didn't say, and we think. Didn't say, and we assume. And we know. that all things work together for good to those who love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. Look at somebody here and say, it will work out. Come on, Bob, your mother is going home. God has all power. Come on, dog. You can't play with my God. Your arm too short to box with my God. My God is more powerful than my it. Can I get a witness? It will work out. I know, God. I ain't thinking about it. Amen. I ain't confused about it. I know that whatever it is, it is going to work out. Can I get a witness? I just wish I had somebody here who knew that it is going to work out. Whatever it is, I don't care what the doctor said. I don't care what mama said. I don't care what daddy said. I don't care what your family said. It will work out. Can I get a witness? I'm so glad that my God has all power. Power to keep you. Power to bless you. Power to watch over you. Power to guide you. And because he has power, you got power. You need to stop letting it cripple you. You need to stop letting it bother you. You need to stop letting it stop you. Nothing can stop you. With God, you are unbeatable. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. I can walk right because I got power to walk right. I can talk right because I got power to talk right. I can get right because I got power to get right. It will. As a matter of fact, will you declare it? Will you declare it today that it will work out? The enemy thought he had Jesus when he nailed him to the cross. But you didn't take my life. I laid it down. Can I get a witness? Because I know that there's going to be a third day before Friday. You thought you had me, but the devil is a liar. He allowed me to be crucified so that he can resurrect me. Can I get a witness? Come on, help me, Lord. And early Sunday morning, after 3 days in the grave, the Bible says he got up. Get up. You can make it. You can do it. Touch yourself and say, I can do it. Help your neighbor and say, you can do it too. Whatever it is, it don't matter what it is. All things are working together. Because he got up with all power in his hand, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. And I know that life is worth the living because my Savior lives. So you be careful. I'm gonna talk to my, can I talk to my aunt right now? You better leave God's children alone. You better stop troubling God's children. Come on, because when God gets ready, he can deal with it, can he? It will work out. The doors of our church are open. Somebody knows that all things are working together. My ex, all things are working together.